Some dread morning when his life is o'er, I will fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away
in the morning
when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. When the shadows of life have grown, I'll fly away. Like a bird from prison bars have flown, I'll fly away. Never end, I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away
in the morning
when I die. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Amen.
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 What's her name?
Nancy Sears.
I want to dedicate this that song we just did to Nancy Sears. Hope you enjoyed it. We're just here to have church with you all tonight. We just pray that something we do or some song we sing or the message a pastor has will be just what you need to hear tonight.
Amen.
We'll just bless you in a mighty way. And if there just happened to be anybody out there watching tonight that hadn't accepted Christ as their Savior, please do so tonight before it's everlasting too late. This may be the last chance you get, and I guarantee you, if you accept him, you'll never regret it.
Amen.
If you have any prayer requests or song requests, there's a number on the bottom of the screen. Just call in. We'll do all the prayer requests, and we'll do as many of the song requests as we can. Before we get into it, though, I'm going to ask Brother Ron if he'll have a blessing on the service.
Our precious Heavenly Father, again, Lord, we thank you for another day that you've given us, so we have fellowship and to really to feel the presence of your Spirit as you walk with us through life, Lord. We ask you now, Lord, to be with this program tonight. Be with all those who are out there, and we hope, Lord, that everything that we do, whereas a song, testimony, the preachers and all, will do something to make somebody's eyes open up and see just what is going to come in the future, how we need to get prepared for the things that are there.
Yeah.
And we ask you now, Lord, to be with those in the nursing home, the hospitals, and those at home that are going through sickness, and especially those, Lord, who many other hard times and things. May they, Lord, look to you and understand that regardless of what we face, you can take care of any problem thing which we have. Now, Lord, again, I said, anoint everything that we do this night, and we'll give you the praise for asking your precious holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Page 204. The next song we're going to do is When the Roll is Called Up Yonder. You know, we're waiting for that time when that roll is called.
Amen.
You know that if your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, when that roll is called, your name will be called too. So when you want to get your name put in that Lord's Book of Life.
Amen.
When the roll is called up yonder.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair. When the great earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection share, when the chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. us labor for the master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all the life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
Amen.
208. The next song we're going to do is Farther Along. You know, a lot of times people just don't understand why it seems like the sinless out in the world right now, and they're just getting away with everything and getting everything, and the Christians don't seem to be getting anything. But, you know, a lot of people say, well, how can that be? But, you know, farther along, we'll understand it one of these days when the Lord will come, and we'll have everything, and they'll have nothing. Farther Along.
Tempted and tried, we're all fate to wonder why it should be thus all the day long. While there are others living about us, never molested, loving the wrong. Farther along we'll know all about it. Farther along we'll understand why.
When we see you.
coming in glory. When he comes from his home in the sky, then we shall meet him in that bright mansion. We'll understand it all by and by. Farther along we'll know all about it. Farther along we'll understand why. Cheer up, my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it all by and by.
Yes, we will.
Amen. How true that is. We got some requests there. Will brought right in for Wings of a Dove, for Joy Alish, and Long Black Train for Ron Bennett, for Irma Zickafoos, and Ernie and Shirley Gifford, and Flowers for Mama, Ron Linger sang, for Ernie and Shirley.
Okay.
So I'll just lay these requests over here, and you fellas can work on them.
All right.
All right.
Next song we're going to do is Where We'll Never Grow Old.
Oh,
amen.
You know, we're looking for that land where we'll never grow old. Cause, you know, some of us in here are beginning to get silver-haired and all of that stuff. And you know, there's a place up there that where we'll never grow old.
Amen. So, when they saw me here 30 years ago on this television, I didn't have hardly any of that.
I have heard of a land on a faraway strand. Is a beautiful home of the soul, built by Jesus on high, where we never shall die. Is a land where we'll never grow old. Never grow old. Happy praise to the King, who eternity sing. Is a land where we never shall die. Never grow old, where we'll never grow old. In a land where we'll never grow old. Never. Troubles and trials are o'er. All our sorrows will end, and our voices will blend with the loved ones who's gone on before. Never grow old, where we'll never grow old, in a land where we'll never.
Feel like shouting, well, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Next song we're going to do is How Beautiful Heaven Must Be, and we want to send it out to Bud Heflin. We hope you enjoy this song. I understand that it's your favorite song. So.
And Bud, we hope and pray that you get to doing better and just get to feeling really good and getting up and just dancing a jig. So this does, it goes out to you, Bud.
How beautiful heaven must be.
We read of a beautiful heaven prepared for the pure and the free. These truths God's word he has given, how beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. And heaven no drooping nor pining, no wishing for elsewhere to be. God's light is forever there shining. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. I'm longing to go to fair heaven, to be with the happy and free. To spend the long ages in singing, how beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be. The angels so sweetly are singing up there by the beautiful sea. Sweet clouds and their gold harps are ringing. How beautiful heaven must be. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free. Fair haven of rest for the weary. How beautiful heaven must be.
Oh, yes. Amen.
This time we'll turn it over to the pastor.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, folks. Hey, Joe. All right. Jim Dale. Bless you, darling. All right. We'd like to say good evening once again to each one of you folks. Thankful that you've turned into the broadcast this evening. And God just blesses us here. We have a wonderful time before the camera comes on, while it's on, and even after it goes off, we go away knowing it's been a good place to be. We hope and pray that you've already been blessed. And if you haven't been, maybe something will be said in the message that will encourage you, that will strengthen you. We got another request here for Sweet Hour of Prayer for Star Teets and want us to be together in heaven for Ethel Simon. So these folks are going to come back and sing in a little while. Maybe they'll get these songs for you. But right now, we'd like to move forward and go into the Word of God and share what the Lord has for us to give to you this evening, because we always seek His guidance and His direction. If you have your Bible, sir, close at hand, we want you to turn to the book of Ecclesiastes. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1, and we're going to begin reading at the first verse. And I'll give you just a moment to look this up so you'll know that we're reading together from the Word of God. It is a joy to be here. We're thankful for each one of you that support us with your prayers and finances, because without you and the movement of the Holy Spirit, this wouldn't be possible. Now, Ronnie mentioned about my hair being so white. It started turning white when I was 13, and Dad was completely the great time he was 30. I didn't quite make that, but I've got a lot of gray hair. And we missed Daryl not being here this evening. I told him I missed the glow about him when he takes his hat off. He just shines with just his head washed up nice and clean. And we torment one another, and the Lord wants us to have a good time. This is the day the Lord has made. Excuse me, let's be glad and rejoice in it. Looking to God's holy word from the book of Ecclesiastes, we're going to begin reading with the first verse of the first chapter. And there it says, "And the words of the preacher, the son of David, king in Jerusalem, vanity of vanity, saith the preacher, vanity of vanities, all is vanity. What profit hath a man of all his labors which he taketh under the sun? One generation passeth away, another generation cometh, but the earth abideth forever. And the sun also arise, and the sun goeth down, and hasteneth to his place where he arose. And the wind goeth toward the south, and turneth about to the north, and it whirleth about continually, and the wind returneth again according to his circuits. And all the rivers run into the sea, yet the sea is not full. And to the place from whence the rivers come, thither they return again." Excuse me. "All things are full of labor. Man cannot utter it. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor the ear filled with hearing. And the thing that hath been, it is that which shall be. And that which is done, is that which shall be done. And there is no new thing under the sun. Is there anything wherefore it may be said, see, this is new? It hath been already of old times, which was before us. There is no remembrance of former things, neither shall there be any remembrance of things that are to come, with these that shall come after." Let us bow our heads for a moment of prayer. Oh, gracious and wise Heavenly Father, as we enter your presence, we thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to go out tonight by the way of television. What a joy it is to know that we are serving you, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And Lord, with all of the wisdom and knowledge and understanding that we have, it doesn't even scratch the surface of how great you really are. Now, Lord, we ask you to give us the words that we would speak this evening to your children, Lord, to your people that's watching, and to those that are lost, Lord, that it'll touch them, it'll bless them, and Lord, that we'll all lift you up, that all men might be drawn unto you. And Lord, we just place all of our cares upon you, and for these things we ask in Jesus' name, and amen, and amen. As we look at this book of Ecclesiastes, Solomon wrote this book in a way to show us that even with all of his wisdom, all of his knowledge, all of his understanding, and he could ask for many other things. God asked him what it was that he would give him, and he asked for wisdom to know the people going in and coming out and knowing how to rule the people as he was king in Jerusalem. Well, folks, we need to seek more wisdom and knowledge from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He has a perfect love and a perfect joy. And when we look out and we see things turning into the fall season, we know it won't be long till the old leaves will be changing, frost will be coming, and things will get a little colder. And we see the times of the seasons. And, you know, it just seemed like yesterday summer began. And it won't be long till it'll be Christmas and then right back to springtime all over again. And with the changing of the seasons, we also are told here that generations come and generations go, but the earth abideth forever. God established this earth in which we live to be established forever. John the Revelator saw that new city, that new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven as a bride adorned for her husband. And he saw the great beauty there, and he saw all the things that will be hereafter. But many times in our lifetime, a lot of people anymore are looking up family tree and old records and things, and that's a good thing to see where you've come from and what's going on. But what most important you need to know is when you were born again, when you accepted Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior, and you became part of a royal family. And we look back as we had homecoming at Sago Sunday, our church picnic. Had a wonderful bunch of food there. We got some of the best cooks in the world. We're thankful for every one of them. And, you know, I've never eaten any better than what you can eat at a church picnic, because ladies really give it their best. And some men do, too. We got some men cooks as well. But we know and realize that over the years, if we have served the Lord, there has been many homecoming dinners, many revivals, many preachers, and many things in our lifetime that we've seen come to pass. But we know and realize that many people forget before the next generation even starts about what happened the generation before. And God wants us to remember. He wants us to know of His greatness. I'm listening to some of my CDs of the scripture that are written down, and they read that often as I go down the highway. I listen to the Word of God, and it blesses me over and over. Even the words that I've heard over and over again seem to have new meaning. And I don't have anything new to preach to you here tonight. We've been on this broadcast for probably better than 30 years now, and Ped and Brother Paul Dickfus and Mavis and all these others that used to be here, the Lord done called them on to be with them. So it's our duty to continue on the work that the Lord has set up. And if the Lord tarries long enough, I'll be laying this old body down, and the Lord will have someone else in mind to come and to share the good news, the gospel with you. And the gospel is not just Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, but it's the good news of Jesus Christ and Him crucified and Him doing everything that needed to be done that I could have life and have it more abundantly. Jesus died for the vilest of sinners. He died for the dope addicts and for the alcoholics and for all of the evil people. Those are the ones that needs a doctor. Those are the ones that need to be saved. And you know, one day I was an old sinner boy myself. And the Lord touched me with His Holy Spirit and guided me to an altar of prayer, and I accepted Him as my Lord and Savior. And as Ronnie said many times, I've never been sorry that I did. There's been times I've wandered from the Lord, and He said, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And that means everybody, folks. And no one is excluded from that except Jesus Christ Himself. As we look at this, generations pass away. The sun comes up of a morning. And, you know, it seemed like when you get up early of a morning, and the old sun coming up. I remember the years driving up the road in the old school bus, the sun rising. And my morning is such a beautiful time. But it seemed like you'd no more make that morning run and get all your morning chores done and to be afternoon run and you'd see the sun going down. I remember the years that we had the Vesper services back on the hill. You know, you'd see that sun going down, and what a beautiful thing it is to behold. But it's not long from the time it sets till the time it rises again. I heard on the news this evening that if the skies were clear tonight, you could go out and start looking for meteor showers and see the great things that are in the heavens that God has created. And folks, there's been meteor showers before. There's been things like this take place. Is there really anything new, Solomon said here? Is there anything that really hasn't happened before? Folks, God is in charge of all things. Solomon talked about the rivers and how they run down and they go into the sea. And when they get to the sea, it seems that, you know, it's never full. Because once it gets to the sea, then God begins to send the clouds over the ocean and the sea, and it begins to lift the water up from there, and it would hold in the clouds and take it back out across the land and begin to rain and shower down. And the water continues its circuits on and on and on. And we know that just as many people as were born today, you know, will be born tomorrow, and just as many as were called out into eternity today will be called out tomorrow. We used to sing that old song, maybe it's you. And maybe it's me. Maybe we'll be the next to face eternity. We don't know. So we need to make preparation for the life hereafter. Make preparations in knowing that all things that God is the author and finisher of. And it says that there comes a time that the ears are not satisfied with hearing. The eyes are not satisfied with seeing. And we see so many people that are unsatisfied today. I remember an old guy lived back toward Holly Grove one time. And he's had a farm back there. And, of course, he's already went to be with the Lord as well. And there was a fellow came in one time and asked him, said, would you sell your farm? And he said, no, I've been here all my life. There's no need to go anywhere else. And Well, I told him, said, you mean if man offered you $1 million for this farm, you wouldn't take it? He said, buddy, I want you to know one thing. Some of the most miserable people I've ever seen has been millionaires, and because they wasn't satisfied when they got what they thought that they wanted. Now, God wants us to prosper, and he wants us to do well, but we need to look at things that God has given us, and we need to be thankful in all things, because if we're not thankful and faithful in the smaller things, we'll never get much more. God wants us to continually move forward into progress in our Christian lives. Now, it's okay to progress in finances, but what's more important is progressing in your daily walk with Christ. The time that you spend with him each day, your personal relationship with the Lord. There's nothing more important than that. The being in the center of God's will and just feeling those blessings pour out upon you. And Solomon said here, he said, there's been evil since the beginning. And there's nothing really new under the sun. But folks, we need to look toward God, the author and finisher of our faith. And that brings us to the other scripture that I want to share with you this evening, taken from the book of Hebrews, the 12th chapter, which goes right along with what we just read there a moment ago. 12th chapter of Hebrews, verse number 1. Wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witness, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down on the right hand of the throne of God. My, what a wonderful passage that is. We know and realize that Solomon learned in his later years. He said there was nobody that God had given wisdom like they'd given it to Solomon. But Solomon learned that the more you learn, the more knowledge, the more distress, the more grief. And many people today are distressed. We live in a society in which there's so much information. You could go on a computer. You can turn on your television set. There are just so many things that you can get information from. But you know, sometimes I think we're just overburdened with information. Don't know how to deal with all of it, and don't know which direction to turn. And the Lord said the time would come, that the times would be perilous, and people would be running to and fro trying to find peace and joy and contentment and not find it. Folks, when I'm the most content is when I'm out just being the Lord. Whether I'm sitting on an old log in the woods or down on a chair by the old river bank or just sitting there or pitching a few rocks in the river and just thinking about the greatness of God. And the more I think about God and the more that I see of him, the more I realize I only scratch the surface. At this point, I don't even really know how to worship and praise God to its fullest extent. But one day when we're taken from this old body and we meet Christ face to face there in the air, he says, we're going to be just like him. And we're going to know exactly how to praise and honor and worship him. Jesus, I'm sure, really didn't want to go to the cross, but that wasn't a fear for him. He knew that he was going to be shamed and that all of your sins and mine were going to hang on him there that day. But he was willing to make that sacrifice, that he could give and go through the cross and give forgiveness to mankind, which were created, and then return to the right hand of the Father. What a wonderful honor that is to sit on the right hand of God. That is a privilege that only Jesus Christ has. Now, the Lord has a place set aside for us in heaven. He said he went to prepare a place, and if he does that, he'll come back and receive us again unto himself. That where he is, we can be as well. And as I see my dear friends leaving, I never sing that old song, Never Grow Old, but what I don't think of Ped Lewis. And old Ped, he used to tell Bud Brown, as sat there at the piano, said, play a verse of that for it. That's just so pretty, I want to listen to it. And sometimes, I just want to listen to how pretty things are. The Lord puts so much out there in beauty that we can see and we can hear. And, you know, I was talking to a couple the other evening, and I told them, you know, what's really a blessing for me, see an old man, an old woman, maybe after being married for 50, 60 years, going down the street holding hands. Maybe got their arms around one another. And I'll tell you, there's just nothing prettier than the love that God places within your heart. Not only just for God, but for your fellow man. And you find more forgiveness, and you're not as quick to judge as maybe you'd be. And you and I have no right to judge anyone, because we ourselves are just sinners saved by the grace of God. So lifted up by His blood, that we can have an eternal home in heaven. If you're watching this evening and you don't know Christ, you accept Him. Just ask Him to be Lord of your life. And then we want you to go to church somewhere. Go out to a good Bible-based church and read your scripture and to share with others the blessings that God has put in your life. And I'll tell you, your life will never be the same once you have taken Jesus Christ in as your Savior. What a joy it is to read from the Holy Scriptures, knowing and realizing that His Word is truth. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by Christ and Christ alone. He didn't say, I'd heard about the truth or I know about it. He said, I am the truth, and that's Jesus Christ. We want to go over the prayer request this evening. Special prayer for May Collins. All right. Special prayer for May Collins, Calvin Cutright, Gene Starr, Joy Davis, Joanne Jones, Glenn Tenney, Jerry Kimball, has had surgery, and Julie McDaniels, Randy Collins, Darlene Cutright, Diana Riffle, Mary Godfrey, Barbie Mackey, and Patricia Riffle, Dottie and Becky Davis, Jim Morgan, and Ann Brown. And for Jimmy Russell, we want to remember Jimmy, that God will continue to bless him, Star Teats and family, and all the friends at the High Rise. And we want to remember each one of these. And for Bud Heflin, and for many others we know, for Mom Winkfield, for Mom Lewis, we hope you're feeling better this evening after you had your test today. And for Junior and Patty Racing, and we just know that God's going to reach out. And if your name hasn't been mentioned, God knows who you are, and we keep you up in our prayers that God will bless you. And we know the importance of you calling, and we take it seriously. For Mary Todd this evening, Mary, it's always good to hear from you, and we know and realize that God is still in the saving business, and we know that He's in the healing business as well. So let's put our faith and trust in the Lord. Father, as we enter Your presence, we thank You for the message that You've given so freely this evening. We thank You, Lord, for each one that is called in tonight. You know the need in their life. And Lord, we ask that You'd bless them in a great and a mighty way. Be their comfort and strength, Lord, and encourage them each day. Now, Lord, we just pray that You would be with most of all those that are lost in sin. Lord, touch them in such a way that they'll accept You as Lord and Savior. And we leave them safe in Your care, trusting in Your judgments, Lord, because You're always right. And for these things we ask in Jesus' name. And amen and amen. May God bless you and keep you till we can be with you again. Group's going to come back and going to sing some until we go off the air. Good night. Bless you, Ron.
Okay, I want to do about three songs for you tonight. And this first song I want to do is The Blood Is Still There. And, you know, it's one of Weiss's favorite songs, too. And I love this song, and it has good meaning to it. I'd like to send it out to Cleo Wingfield, Vanny Cornell, Gus Allender, Teddy and Troy, Harold and Elsie Lewis, Luella and Maynard Hannafin, Henry and Jesse Friend. Send it out also to my cousin Loretta out in Ohio. I hope you enjoy this one. The Blood Is Still There. One dark night in Egypt, a fearful time had come for one little Hebrew boy who was his father's firstborn son. Now with the angel of death
passing low. It was hard to fall asleep, but one little lamp stood in his mind as he laid there counting sheep. He wondered why the young lamb had to die, why his blood was on the door. Through the wind and rain, had it still remained, but he wanted to be sure. So he cried out to his earthly father with a trembling voice so scared, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the blood is still there?" And he said, "Son, now don't you worry, for the blood is there to stay. The wind may blow and the rain may fall, but it won't just wash away. The blood will stand the rage and storm. It's been applied with loving care. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there." Looking over the damage Satan's storms had left behind, the flood of endless questions, doubt had filled my mind. The fear that gripped my troubled soul brought me back on my knees in prayer, crying, "Father, will you please look and see if the blood is still there?" And he said, "Son, now don't you worry, for the blood is there to stay. The wind may blow and the rain may fall, but it won't just wash away. The blood will stand the rage and storm. It's been applied with loving care. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there. Safe, secured, you can rest assured that the blood is still there." Next song I want to sing is for I'm Free, and I want to send it out to Ronnie Rogers and his wife Janet, and Barry Beckner and his wife, Charlie Allen and his wife, and Gary and his wife. Several of my friends, it seems like every time I get up here, I get a little tongue-tied because I'm trying to remember all of them I want to send it out to, but it's called I'm Free. So long I have searched for life's meaning. It's slayed by this world and my dreams. Then the door of my prison was opened by love. The ransom was paid and now I'm free. I'm free from the fear of tomorrow. I'm free from the guilt of the past. For I traded my shackles for a glorious song. I'm free, well, praise the Lord, I'm free at last. I am free from the guilt that I carry. From this dark, empty blank, I'm set free. For when I met my Jesus, he made me complete. Well, he forgot the foolish one I used to be. I'm free from the fear of tomorrow. I'm free from the guilt of the past. For I traded my shackles for a glorious song. I'm free, well, praise the Lord, I'm free at last. I'm free, well, praise the Lord, I'm free at last. And the next one we'll send out to
Ernie and Shirley Gifford, and to Cat Channel, my buddy Cat. It's his favorite song, and likes for me to do it for him all the time. And I hope you all don't get tired of it. It's just a beautiful song, and Cat loves it. Also, I want to send it out to Gary Holland and his wife. Papa brought flowers for Mama today, and all the grown children, but it's not Mother's Day. I don't have no money, not even a dime, but I brought Mama flowers like I have all the time. Each day I pick flowers from this pretty hill, a small bunch of daisies and a few daffodils. I bring them to Mama at the end of the day and say, flowers for Mama, here's Mama's bouquet. They'd brighten her face and she'd hold me so close. She'd say they were more precious than a beautiful rose. And she wore a smile sweeter than millions of flowers, a smile that I'll carry through life's darkest hours. Yes, Mama was lying there, and they told me that she'd passed away. And she was surrounded by flowers that outshine my bouquet. Oh, I know mine aren't fancy, but still all the while, when they placed them in her hand, I know I saw Mama smile. Flowers for Mama, I picked them today. Not very much, just a simple bouquet. I know Mom's not fancy, but up there above, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. Yes, she's the prettiest flower in God's garden of love. God bless you all and good night.
Okay, for Julie, what's that? That's on for you, for Lisa to do Wings of a Dove.
And I'll do it for my friend too, Mary Sharp, whose 60th wedding anniversary is tomorrow.
Thank you.
today a request for Emma Sycophus and Ernie and Shirley Gifford want to swing Long Black Train. There's a long black train coming down the line, beating off the souls that are lost in crime. Rail of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption staring right back in your eye. There is protection, there is peace, a saint. Burn your tickets for that long black train. Cause you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. There's a ninja near on that long black train, making you wonder if the ride's worth the pain. He's just waiting on your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Oh, I can hear the whistle from a mile away. It sounds so good, but I must stay awake. That train's a beauty, making everybody stare. But his only destination is the middle of nowhere. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Let's cling to the Father and His holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. Let's watch out, brother, for that long black train. The devil's a-driving that long black train. Here's one, can you find this song for me? Yeah. You may have a fancy car, brand new house that shines afar. You may live to be 100 years old. But if you have not been saved, it all ends with the grave. But I want us to be together in heaven.
Amen.
I want us to be together in heaven. I want to walk down the streets of pure gold. I want to run through the fields of green clover. See the mansion, smell the flyer, hear the singing, it's so hard. See the river of life flowing, feel the gentle breezes blowing. I want us to be together in heaven. You may be some millionaire, wearing clothes beyond compare. You may have the best that money can buy. But if the blood is not applied, then in hell you'll lift your eye. But I want us to be together in heaven. I want us to be together in heaven. I want to walk down the streets of pure gold. I want to run through the fields of green clover. See the mansion, smell the flower, hear the singing, it's so hard. See the river of life flowing, feel the gentle breezes blowing. I want us to be together in heaven.
Bless you, Mom.
We had a request here to want to hear the Sweet Hour Prayer. Don't want to stay down there. Sweet Hour of Prayer. You hold that down there for me. Sweet Hour of Prayer. Sweet Hour of Prayer. That calls me from a world of sin and bids me at my Father's strong, makes all my wants and weaknesses known. In seasons of distress and grief, my soul has often found freely and oft escaped the trumpet snare, but I return, Sweet Hour of Prayer. Sweet Hour of Prayer, Sweet Hour of Prayer, thy wings shall my petition bear to him whose truth and faithfulness engage the waiting souls to bless, and since he bids me seek his way, he leave his words and trust his grace, and cast on him my every care, and wait for thee, Sweet Hour of Prayer. Sweet Hour of Prayer, Sweet Hour of Prayer, may I thy consolation share, till from out Jesus' lofty high, I view my home and take my fight. Of wine I'll drop and ride to see the everlasting pride, and shouts while passing through the air, farewell, farewell, Sweet Hour.